What's up, everybody? Welcome to Videl Entertainment. And this is We Are Videl for Lana Del Rey's album, Lust for Life. I know. It's been a minute. I did a reaction to Tropical, although uploading it sucked because I kept getting blocked, so I had to just keep editing the video. But I did a reaction to Tropical. It was dope to see the visuals on that. If you haven't checked it out, check it out. And now we're continuing with her albums. It's been a minute, y'all. Finally graduated a couple days ago. Got my master's in English literature. I'm done, man. But how y'all been? Y'all been good? So the poll is done for the album I'm going to react to once a week. That's going to be the next upload, is that reaction, that one, which is Electra Heart from Marina. Today, there's another post where you could, again, comment and suggest the albums that y'all want me to react to. I want to engage with y'all. Keep active in the community tabs and just comment what you want me to react to. Upvote the ones that you agree that you want me to react to. The more the merrier. I'm trying to make this into a weekly thing. So remember to pay attention to the community tab. Before we get to this reaction, give this video a like, subscribe to the channel. Let's get to Lana Del Rey, Lust for Life. I know this is the one that has features, so this is gonna be interesting to hear. But we're gonna start with the first track, Love. What's love got to do with it? What's
love? Look, you kids with your vintage music coming through satellites while cruising. You're part of the past, but now you're the future. Signals crossing can get confusing. You get ready, you get all dressed up to go nowhere in particular. Back to work or the coffee shop, doesn't matter, cause it's enough to be
Okay, so that was Love. That was the first track. I know I didn't say anything, but first of all, I feel out of practice because it's just been a while, at least for me, it's been a while. But it's just like, it's so relaxing. Love the energy that this song provides, this youthfulness that this song provides. The simplicity of being your youth. The older you get, the more problems such as show up that you've never seen before, or problems you weren't privy to. So just enjoy youthfulness, the simplicity of things. Love, what an amazing feeling. What an amazing, powerful feeling love is. Yeah, I like this track. It's a great opener. Next track we have is Lust for Life, featuring one of my favorite artists, The Weeknd. I reacted to the unreleased collab that they both had. I thought that was really dope. So can't wait to get to this one. Lust for Life featuring The Weeknd. If it ain't next song, cool.
Climb up the H of the Hollywood sign, yeah. In these stolen moments, the world is mine. There's nobody here, just us together.
I bet. Nah, I'm fucking with you. Hell no.
We dance on the H of the Hollywood sign. Yeah. Till we run out of breath. Gotta dance till we die. My boyfriend's back. And he's cooler than ever.
I love these lyrics. I like that. Now he's singing it. So he's starting it. That's interesting. That's dope. Okay. A little role reversal. I'm reading the lyrics. That's why I know it. I'm reading the lyrics. That's why I'm able to lip sync it. Oh, it's all good fun. It's all good fun. Take off all your clothes. Take off all your clothes. Imagine Lana Del Rey serenading you with that. Just the way she sings that. Just take off your clothes. I'm mad melodramatic, dog. I'm mad melodramatic. Oh, that was Lust for Life featuring The Weeknd. I like this track. It was good. It was fun. I know I'm playing. I see that this is an Iggy Pop reference, which is dope. But I love like the free spirit of this song. I love how carefree the song is. Not caring about others, just living the moment. That's why, you know, they want to take... That's why they want you to take off your clothes. Not me. That's dumb. I swear to you. It's The Weeknd and Lana that's saying that. It's not me. I really enjoyed the chemistry between The Weeknd and Lana. The way that they switched some of these lines was also pretty cool too. This is funny. Oh my God. Why do I keep doing this? Why should I just start reaching? I'm tired of this. But y'all watch me. So in the first track, Love, in the first verse, she says, "You're part of the past, but now you're the future." And in Lust for Life, I'm just seeing because of the references. He referenced a lot of doo-wop by saying doo-wop. He referenced Iggy Pop and also Frank Sinatra. So she's referencing the past music while still talking about living the present and being free in the present. So it's funny how that's just connected with love and lust. That's dope. Next track we have is 13 Beaches. 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 Beaches, beaches. Ever since Lil Wayne said life is a beach, I'm just playing in the sand. I just can never say that word right. 13 beaches. Just sounds like I'm saying bitches with an accent.
It took 13 beaches to find one empty.
Damn.
But finally it's mine. But I still get lonely, and baby, only then do I let myself recline across that county line. It hurts to love you, but I still love you. It's just the way I feel. And that I've been
I hear that.
It took 13 beaches.
I wish I had that type of time and money.
Yeah.
I feel like I should be drinking wine to this. Because it's not really hitting me. Because, like, the chorus feels underwhelming for me. Like, there's, like, this strong buildup for the chorus. I feel like it should have been, like, a bigger payoff. Y'all really about to have me drinking wine. Y'all really about to have me drinking wine. At 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Oh, it's fuck, it's brunch time, like mimosas. You know, it's like brunch. You know, you get to drink around 12, 1 o'clock. But that was 13 beaches. Beaches. It sounds like I'm saying with an accent. I get the purpose of this track. You know, Lana always talks about her fame, how paparazzis could be freaking annoying, which I know we could all empathize with. Like, these are people. Like, give them their personal space, you know what I mean? I'm all about that. And it sucks, like, you just want to go to a beach and you keep having to travel for something so simple to find a good beach because there's so many paparazzis following all that. Even finding a place in Ventura, which I know is in California, thanks to Anderson .Paak. Thank you. Great album. But yeah, that was 13 Beaches. I just thought it was underwhelming. Next track we have is Cherry. I'm gonna get hated on that, I know. This is the one. This is the one. We just started the album. This is the one, though. This is the one. I just peeped the trap drums. I just peeped that. Different from Lana. Bitch. 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 Right, bitch. Bitch. We can do the low shit. Bitch. Bitch. Oh, man. If you get that reference, I fucks with you. If you get that reference, if you know the song, comment that down below if you know the song. I fucks with you already. I already fucks with you. That was Cherry. I really enjoy the chorus on that. I understand the reference with peaches and Cherry. Her peaches are ruined. And before, that was like a good thing. What she talks about with dripping peaches, I'm camera ready. If you're listening to 112 Peaches and Cream, y'all know what peaches mean. You know, in this track, Cherry, everything is ruined. Her time at the beach, her relaxing time, which you just, you know, could chill, be by herself, is just ruined by fucking people. Like always, man, people ruin everything, dude. Let's just get to the next track, which is White Mustang. No, we got Frank Ocean, White Ferrari. Now we got Lana Del Rey, White Mustang. Yeah, okay, these celebrities with the white cars. And the meaning.
Packing all my things for the summer. Lying on my bed, it's a bummer, cause I didn't call when I got your number, but I liked you a lot. The day I saw your white Mustang, your white Mustang. The day I saw your white Mustang, your white Mustang.
I see that this song referenced Lana's Born to Die music video, that there's a white Mustang. So luckily, because I'm able to know the context of this track, yeah, I was definitely right that the music videos really tie into like her whole entire music. Because not many artists do that. I don't know any artist that actually does that. Like incorporate the music videos into their music as in like part of the story, like it's canon. You know how like Marvel is doing that? Disney TV shows like WandaVision and Loki, and like these shows are part of like the Marvel Cinematic Universe, even though that they're TV shows, they're part of the movies. It's like the same thing with Lana Del Rey. It's like the music video is part of her albums, her the stories in her albums. That's interesting. Luckily, I'm able to know the explanation on it. The drums are dope in this track. It's just so different. That was White Mustang. Be honest with me. Like, really be honest with me. Do y'all enjoy this track? Do y'all like this song? Like, it's not bad. It's not a bad track. But it's just like, I've heard Lana do so much better in her other albums. I'm not even talking about NFR. I'm talking about just Born to Die. I think it's better. It just sounds like a filler track to me, you know? And with the repetition of, like, that White Mustang, I get it. Like, she's trying to, like, really emphasize the symbolism of the White Mustang, which symbolizes the boyfriend or this guy. Just like a car revving it up, coming and going in the summer, like, tired of that shit. Like, you know, associating the White Mustang with a dude. I do like the drums in this track. It's not because it's slow either. It's not because of that. I know that's like a common theme, you know. I embrace it. It's funny. I don't mind it at all. But, you know, I'm looking for a bit more. A bit more. But if you like it, cool. I ain't mad at it. But speaking of summer and bummer, which was the first lines of the track, now we get to the next track, Summer Bummer, featuring ASAP Rocky and Playboi Carti. And Carti, then I'm sorry. These two are some of my favorite artists. I really fucks with ASAP Rocky. Love his music. I really fucks with Playboi Carti. Like, I enjoy a whole lot of Red when it first came out. I feel like Playboi Carti is gonna kill it. I feel like he's gonna do amazing on this track. He always does amazing on R&B, soul, and pop music, even when you least expect it. Like Almeida with Solange, he was flowing on that. Earthquake with Tyler the Creator, Playboi Carti was flowing on that. Like, there's something about pop and R&B songs that Carti just shines. And ASAP Rocky, I know he's gonna flow. That's his biggest skill, is his flow. Like, this dude's flow switches is crazy. Let's get to Summer Bummer. I'm excited for this one. I'm really excited for this one.
It's never too late to be who you wanna be. Say what you wanna say. Yeah. I got a feeling in my bones.
I heard Carti.
Can't get you out of my veins.
Okay, I'm liking this build up.
You can't escape my affection.
The Carti Alice.
What? You're my undercover lover, babe.
Ooh. Be my undercover lover, like that. Be my side hoe. Okay.
Her sophistication make you wanna quit the bitch you dating. Let's skip the games, let's quit the playing. Boo, let's get acquainted. Notifications sink in place even when we on vacation. I knew she'd notice like I missed the payment. Dang it. Slide inside it. Diddy Bobby, Manny Rocky. She just might become my lover for real.
So is Carti just on the ad-libs? Okay. I get it. Carti's ad-libs is amazing. Like, that's his signature. I get Carti's ad-libs is his signature. He's dope for it. But, you know, like, give him something, something. Even Tyler the Creator gave him something. Solange gave him something. You know, a little spot to shine, you know?
Better run for cover for real. Go to bail, how I feel. Close the deal, pop a sale. Take the whip, two pills on the list, on the rail.
Truthfully, between you and me, I'm usually single when it's hot outside.
This floor is
any hood with the top out. Hop out, hop out.
That pocket, I like that pocket. That pocket was dope. Oh, Boy Wonder did the drums. Nice. See, Minus was on this. Nice.
Be my babe. Be my undercover lover, babe. Where lights can black beaches, miles in between us. Is this love or lust or some game on repeat? It's like making me crazy. Tell me, have patience, baby. I need this. White lines and black beaches. Hip hop in the summer. Don't be a bummer, babe. Be my undercover lover, babe.
was Summer Bummer featuring ASAP Rocky and Playboi Carti. Cash Carti. I thought it was a good track. I know, right? Yeah, I expected me to really love it. I thought it was a good track, though. It's dope. I see T-Minus and Boy Wonder help produce this beat, along with Big White Beats and Jahan Sweet, who I'm not familiar with. I like the chorus on this. It was dope. Rocky's verse was cool. I think Lana actually outshined Rocky, and I mean that by a lot. I think the last couple lines from Rocky, when he just hit that pocket of flow, was good, but I just thought Rocky's verse was just cool. Like, it was just solid. I did wish to hear Playboi Carti beside his ad-libs, but I get it. Like, his ad-libs are dope. It's his signature. But like I said, I just gave him like a little spot of sunshine. Just a little. This is what I'm talking about also when it comes to like Lana Del Rey's writing and how good it is, and why I was disappointed with White Mustang. Like, hear this third verse. White lies and black beaches. Then later on, she says white lines and black beaches. Like, just something simple as that. White lies, right? The little lies, the lies that are not supposed to matter. And black beaches. You know, black beaches, the sand is black. It's usually very exotic type of beaches. But these little lies, like, be my undercover lover. If someone has to be your undercover lover, that means that you're a side piece, right? Or that means that you keep you on the low. So that means that you're telling these small lies that don't really mean anything. Miles in between us, is this love or lust? Like she mentioned in the first two tracks of this album. And then she mentions in the song Love, how love makes her crazy. So I like that reference to the first track as well. White lines and black beaches, white lines, but also the purity of the beach, like the white waves, you know, playing more with the colors. And of course with the white lies, the white lights and the white lines, they are a reference to the White Mustang, which references the guy who is the undercover lover, who she wanted more out of. Playing with the colors, she always plays with the colors. Like I said, this is a good track. I just expected more out of the features. I think Lana did her thing, but I expected more out of her features, which were Rocky and Carti. But speaking of Rocky again, we have Rocky again on Groupie Love. I might shed a tear. This is beautiful singing right now. If she could hit this right now, I might shed a tear. It's like it has so much toxicity in it, but it sounds so beautiful. Like, come on. You are my groupie.
My
Rihanna.
Now.
Rest in peace, ASAP Yams.
My day, stay on my brain. My day made me sing to a fire stay. City girl, though she grew up in a tri-state.
Okay. That was Groupie Love featuring ASAP Rocky. This is a way better verse and performance from ASAP Rocky compared to Summer Bummer. Way better. Yeah, this track was fire. This track was really fucking good. I love how dreamy the chorus was. Even though that's repetition, it's worth it because the buildup, we were building up to the chorus and there was a payoff. You know what I mean? With repetition, there's a fine line. There's a fine line with repetition. It's funny when Rocky says, sing along word for word, watching my bae. And then now we're seeing videos like ASAP Rocky performing and Rihanna is like in the crowd. And she, you know, she she's vibing, she's singing along to the tracks. It's like the same thing. Like, just picture the same thing with Lana Del Rey. Lana Rae is the one that's sitting in the crowd, or, you know, is off to the side. You know, her boo thing or her undercover lover is on stage singing, and she's vibing, she's swinging, all that. She's hoping nobody notices her. This seems nice, even though it says you want my groupie love. It's still very pretty. Next track we have is In My Feelings.
I'm smoking while I'm running on my treadmill, but I'm coming up roses. Could it be that I fell for another loser? I'm crying.
Damn.
I'm coming, making love while I'm making the
Oh my God, I'm tearing. Oh my God.
Just be honest with me. Just be honest with me. When y'all first heard this track and y'all heard, could it be that I fell for another loser? I'm crying while I'm coming. I didn't laugh at that. I didn't laugh at that. It sucks. Let me take that back. It sucks. It does suck. And it shows like that sex meant nothing. You know, it brought her more pain than joy. You're supposed to be euphoric when you climax. Supposed to be an amazing feeling. And I see in here, it's talking about how she dated rapper G-Eazy. Yeah, I get that. I would get why she would cry while coming. I see many women aren't usually happy after dating G-Eazy. Listen, G-Eazy doesn't make good music. He's always carried by the features, like A$AP Rocky and Cardi B. It's okay. Sometimes we miss. Sometimes we miss. It's okay. I'm with you. Ooh. There we go. Why y'all be cheating, man? Be loyal to your partner, golly. Or just don't be in a relationship. This shit gets me heated, yo. Cheating gets me heated.
If it were me and I was you, I'd get out of my way.
Be cautious, be wary of me.
That was In My Feelings. Really great track. Really great track. I like how she embraces how the guy got her in her feelings. Like, you call me slipping. You call me slipping. But I'm going to fall back. Why? Because who's doper than me? Who's freer than me? You see that? You hear the type of music that I make? You want to make the switch? Just be my guest. Just do you. Do you. Damn. I like this line, sobbing in my cup of coffee. It reminds me of Otis Redding's Cigarettes and Coffee. But in that song, Otis is talking about love. You know, loving this woman, just embracing this woman. But, you know, if you hear the song, it's early in the morning, 3:15. Just have my cigarettes and coffee. I see now that coffee is usually associated with love, relationships, intimacy. Like, okay, you want to come over for a cup of coffee? Like, if someone invites you to come over for a cup of coffee, you know what that means. So it's funny, like, she mentions coffee here too, but the coffee is not getting her energetic. She's crying a cup of coffee. So I just noticed that coffee is associated with so much thing when it comes to love and relationships. I just noticed that. But yeah, this track is definitely about her and her feelings, but her coming back and confirming herself and bringing assertiveness too. Next track we have is Coachella, Woodstock in My Mind. R.I.P. to Jimi Hendrix.
I was at Coachella, leaning on your shoulder, watching your husband swing in time.
What?
I turned off the music, tried to sit and use it, all of the love that I saw that night. Cause what about all these children? And what about all their parents?
What do you mean? Stairway to Heaven, Led Zeppelin.
I take my time for the climb up to the top of it. I'd give it all away if you give me just one day to ask
powerful.
Just one day to ask him one question. What about all these children and all their children's children? And why am I
now going with generations? Okay. That was Coachella Woodstock in my mind. I actually like this track. I'm glad I looked up the lyrics because I didn't get the purpose of the track. You know, mentioning Coachella, then mentioning what about all the children. Okay, now I'm understanding. The tension between North Korea and the USA. There's always tension, man. We're the USA. We got tension with every single country. That's how it is. Welcome to fucking America. This is America. Like, we got tension with everybody. Don't matter who it is. Do you know how many coups America has done and also tried to do? How they always try to overthrow like political parties in other countries, especially in Latin America. You know, having some sort of politician to bring democracy to Latin America. You know how many times America has done that? There's always tension, man. There's always tension, especially now, you know, Russia and the Ukraine. Oh man, let me not be political in this video. I got my gripes with this country. This country is not that bad, but I got my gripes. And we know there's a lot more. But again, I don't want to make this video political. But this is a great song. Dope Led Zeppelin reference. Yes, I will get that reference. I listen to rock. Just like how I listen to metal. I listen to all types of music. Man, and just reading this line, because what about all these children and what about all their parents? Especially what happened in Uvalde, Texas. Like, it's sad. It's sad how relevant this track is just in a couple years. Just within a couple years. You know, great song. Great song. Next track we have is God Bless America and All the Beautiful Women in It.
Take me as I am. Take me, baby, in stride. Only you can save me tonight. There's nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. You let me in, don't leave me out, or leave me dry. On the fire escapes of the city.
I love that.
Sounds like I am free.
Fire escapes make buildings look so cooler. Not necessary, but still, ooh. God Bless America and All the Beautiful Women in It. Yo, God bless beautiful women, yo. Man, God bless women. Golly, man. God bless women. This is cool. It's also produced by Metro Boomin, which I didn't know. That's dope to see. Another track that I enjoy. I enjoy this track. I really like this pre-chorus right here. Even when I'm alone, I'm not lonely. I hear the sweetest melodies on the fire escapes of the city. Sounds like I am free. I don't know if you're talking about the cities in California, whether it's LA, or if you're talking about New York City, but in a New York City perspective, being the fire escape, people used to chill in the fire escape, like you and a couple friends just being the fire escape, and you know, some people would drink, smoke, just chill out, and just see the city, see all these lights, the car passes by, hear people play music as that passed by. The city is alive, there's so much things going on, you know. When you get older, you learn to appreciate that. And you understand why people say, do you hear the music in the city? Because it really is. It's beautiful. Hear the conversations. It's a great way to pass time, to chill. That's my favorite. That's my favorite. Next track we have is When the World Was at War, We Kept Dancing.
We just want the fucking truth. Is it the end of America?
Oh, this one Trump got elected? I don't know. I feel like America has always just been like that. Has been this way. We just got older. That's what it is. And we weren't ignorant anymore. I think that's what it is. We just became more politically inclined, more politically aware of what's going on. We feel like, damn, America really, this is like an end for America, but America has always been like this. You know what I mean? I'm not saying anything against what Lana is saying. I'm just saying, like, as we get older, we start to learn the bullshit. We see behind the curtains what's going on behind the show. It sucks. Lana's getting more political in the second half of the album. Like the hippie movement? Yeah, the hippie movement. Here's a quick tangent. There was one time I was watching the History Channel. I used to watch the History Channel back when I was in middle school. And they were talking about the hippie movement, the hippie era, right? Woodstock and all that. How old was that? I think I was 12. So maybe my brother was... Me and my brother was 8 years old and he's watching the History Channel with me. And the History Channel, they like show like the hippies, they show them, you know, they show the girls topless. And so they're like, oh, the hippies did LSD, they did these drugs, weed and all that type of stuff. You know, we're both learning. Apparently my brother brought that up in school. My brother was like maybe in third or fourth grade, maybe fourth grade. And the teacher was like, what? And my brother was like, yeah, you know, the hippies, they did drugs, they did LSD and stuff like that. And they had sex outside. The teacher was like, nah. And they really gave my brother detention. Because he talked about that. My brother was bringing facts. And they're like, nah, you too woke. Attention. My brother had to stay after school. Knowledge is power. Don't let them suppress it. I'm just talking, bro. I'm just talking. Don't forget our toys, our money. I like that part. The distortion too is dope. So that was When the World Was at War, We Kept Dancing. It's dope to see Lana going in this direction in her music. I like this bridge, and we'll do it again. Oh my God, Dizzy from Loving You. We just had the tracks, God Bless America. And you know, Lana talks about appreciation in America. Here she says, when the world was at war, before we just kept dancing. So we're dancing, getting dizzy, probably spinning. Oh my God, Dizzy from Loving You. Like her writing is crazy, man. Her writing is crazy. It's dope. Next track we have is Beautiful People, Beautiful Problems featuring Stevie Nicks. I knew that name sounds familiar. He's a singer for Fleetwood Mac. Definitely heard of Fleetwood Mac. Thank you, Guitar Hero. Go Your Own Way. I knew that song.
Blue is the color of the planet from the view above. Long live our rain, long live our love. We get so tired and we complain about how it's hard to live. It's more than just a video game.
My last song, video game? Like that.
But we're just beautiful people with beautiful problems.
Blue is the color of the shirt of the man I love. Yo, her voice is crazy.
It's hard at work.
It's so dope. That contrast
to the
works so well.
But warm is the body of the girl from the land he loves.
Mm.
My heart is soft. My past is rough.
Beautiful writing from Stevie Nicks. Beautiful writing. Blue is the collar of the shirt of the man I love. A blue collar shirt. Blue collar, like working with your hands, doing physical labor, usually those like trade jobs. He's hard at work, hard to the touch, but warm is the body of the girl from the land he loves. My heart is soft, my past is rough. Oh my God. Oh my God. I could just fall in love from reading that. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. Usually when you work hard, especially with your body, some people just turn cold. They figure become hardened. But warm is the body of the girl from the land he loves. My heart is soft. My past is rough. I've been through a lot. I've been through a lot. Even though I've been through a lot, my heart, my love is still blooming. It's still soft. I still welcome you. I will give you love because I know what it's like to be hard to the touch because my past is rough. I was able to grow and embrace who I am and be able to give love, genuine love. My gosh, beautiful verse from Stevie Nicks. Stephen Nicks works great here.
Beautiful problems, God knows we've got them, but we gotta try. Lie.
So that was Beautiful People, Beautiful Problems featuring Stevie Nicks. Stevie Nicks killed it. She killed it. She did amazing. Amplify this track a lot more from her writing. Fantastic. Next track we have is Tomorrow Never Came featuring Sean Ono Lennon. All y'all know, it's John Lennon's son.
Hey, what you doing? Not a lot. Shaking and moving. Hey, lady, lay on this side of paradise in the traffic of cancer. You would always stay, and I be your tiny dancer, honey. I waited
Elton
for
John.
You in the spot you said to wait, in the city on the park bench, in the middle of the pouring rain.
Hey, what you thinking?
My God.
Penny for your thoughts. Those lights are blinking on that.
This dude's cadence is really like John Lennon. I never heard Sean Lennon sing, but I do know who he is because I used to be really invested into the Beatles back when I was a teenager. But I never actually heard him sing. He really sounds like John Lennon. Like his dad.
But don't ask me why.
Roses out in your country house. We play guitar in your barn. Isn't life crazy, I said, now that I'm singing with Sean.
In the city on the park bench, in the summer on the pouring rain. Honey, don't ignore me, I just wanted it to be the same. Tomorrow never came.
Yeah, that was Tomorrow Never Came featuring Sean Ono Lennon. Yeah, this was a good track. This was a good track. Very calming, very soothing. Enjoy listening to Sean Lennon's voice. Reminds me a lot like John Lennon, especially his cadences and his tone. Yeah, just beautiful, pretty lyrics, great guitar. I see that Sean Lennon played all the instruments on this. I was very inspired by this. Yeah, great track. I like this one. Next track we have is Heroin.
Topanga's heart.
Why?
How I gave you everything and took your life away.
By the way, Fly Me to the Moon from Frank Sinatra is my favorite Frank Sinatra track. Beautiful lyrics. That was Heroin. I think this track was solid. I like the story of this track, to be honest with you. Topanga's hot tonight. I see that as a place in California. And I'm assuming that this place is just like evil. Now I'm flying to the moon again, dreaming about heroin, or just being a drug addict, relying on this, which is destroying your life. Puts you on that aeroplane destined for a foreign land. You gotta take that metaphorically, like when you're high, you're off in another plane, another level. The evils of the city, the side effect and evils of the drugs. This is very dark. Very dark. Next track we have is Change.
There's something in the wind, I can feel it blowing in. It's coming in highly, and it's coming in strong. Lately I've been thinking it's just someone else's job to sympathize when no one gave a damn. Change is a powerful thing. People are powerful beings trying to find the power in me to be faithful. Maybe by the time summer's done, I'll be able to be honest, capable.
You noticed that, right? The change. In the beginning of the album, she talked about the summer and the guy being different, but then, you know, giving the white lies, these lies, right? And now, hear this, change is a powerful thing. I feel it coming in me. Maybe by the time summer's done, I'm able to be honest. Literally a change in character, a change in the story. It's fantastic writing. It's just fantastic writing.
Maybe it's enough to just be where we are, because every time that we run, we don't know what it's from. Now we finally slow down, we feel close to it. It's bitter, I'm coughing, but now it's in my blood. Lately I've been thinking it's just someone else's job to who am I to sympathize when no one gave a damn?
I just realized maybe this album is not about a dude. It's just been about America and the society that we're living in. In the earlier track, she's talking about summer being fun and enjoying summer. And she's tired of like these white lies. And she's hoping the guy would change, but the guy never changes. Maybe she wasn't talking about a guy. She was talking about America. You know, it's just an interesting thought to have. You know, summer, we all have fun, enjoy ourselves. School is out. It's the time we're not supposed to really care so much. We're supposed to spend time with our families, times with our friends, be very social, go out. These are lies. They don't last long. Seeing it from that lens really changed this album for the better. Yeah, this is great. This is great.
Change is a powerful thing. People are powerful beings trying to find the power in me to be faithful. Maybe it's enough to just be where we are.
because every time that we run, we don't know what it's from. Now we finally slow down, we feel close to it. There's a change gonna come. I don't know where or when, but whenever it does, we'll be here for it.
That was Change. That line right there, there's a change gonna come, I don't know where or when, remind me of Sam Cooke's A Change Is Gonna Come. Beautiful song, amazing song. Sam Cooke, amazing, phenomenal singer. If you haven't listened to that song, please do, please do. But you know, that was definitely a different time. I assume that she's making a reference to Sam Cooke because she makes references to a lot of old singers back in the 1900s. I said 1900s. And it's like she's continuing that. There's a change gonna come, I don't know where or when. But of course it's different because Sam Cooke is a black man and Lana is a white woman. But I understand the sentiment, hoping for a change to come. She talks about hope quite a few times in this album. I view life with a glass half full. I'm mostly an optimist, but sometimes I think to myself, am I an optimist? Is this signs of optimism? Or am I just being naive? Do I just accept reality for what it is? Yeah, this is actually becoming a great album. But let's finish the album with the last track, Get Free.
Finally, I'm crossing the threshold from the ordinary world to the reveal of my heart. This is my commitment, my modern manifesto.
I like this chorus.
I never really noticed that I had to decide to play someone's game or live my own life, and now I do. I wanna move out of the black,
out of the black,
into the blue.
Out of the black, black and blue. You know, we think about black and blue, like a black and blue eye. We think about pain, a bruise. In this context, moving out of the black, like moving out of depression, sadness, into the blue. She talks about the blue skies a lot throughout this album. Something that's beautiful and also hopeful, natural.
There's no more chasing rainbows and hoping for an end to them. Their arches are illusions, solid.
Interesting.
Sometimes it feels like I've got a war in my mind. I wanna get off, but I keep riding the ride. I never really noticed that I had to decide to play someone's game or live my own life.
That was the last track of the album, Get Free. I think this was a great closer. That was a great track, great closer. I gotta say this before I forget it, because what I'm about to say, I might be reaching. But I understand why this album is called Lust for Life. We get the first track with Love, and she's talking about, you know, kids, children, right? Look at you kids with your vintage music. Talking about like the simple thing. Look at you kids, you know you're the coolest. Simple things, right? And just appreciating and enjoying that. Back to work or the coffee shop. Oh my God, fuck, yo. Lana is a great writer. We need to appreciate her pen, because she just had the other line about sobbing while drinking coffee. And then she talked about, you know, being a child, being a kid, going back to work or the coffee shop, just the simple things, enjoying that and how lovely that is. And then as you get older, you know, that coffee that you have, you start to, I don't know, you start to cry, but you know, it's not as tasteful as it used to be. It's not as happy as it used to be. The real world starts to really settle in. When we think about lust, right? Lust is very shallow. It's very superficial, right? Damn, you're hot, I'm hot. You know, get two bodies in a bed and just, you know, do our thing, right? Lana talks about crying while she's coming. You know, things are not as great as it is. Lust isn't great. You know, it's very shallow, surface level. Now there's no depth to it. And like throughout this album, we get this development for Lana where she starts to grow and mature. She starts to learn like the horrors of the world, the tension I see between North Korea and America, and now the tension, you know, with Russia and what's going on, and also the tension within this country, within the US, especially the gun violence and the police brutality, being politically aware. And with tracks like God Bless America and When the World Was at War, We Kept Dancing, we get these politically aware tracks and Lana understanding the horrors. And then towards the end with Change and Get Free, like how she hopes for change, how she is optimistic and not the person that she once was, and hoping for a better future. That's how with Coachella Woodstock in my mind, she says, thinking about the children, because she wants the future to be better for the next generation. Unfortunately, in 2022, we're at the point where children aren't living long enough to know if the generation will be better than the last generation. They aren't even living long enough to see that. You know, it's depressing, it's sad, you know. This is a great album. Like, there's a theme to it that ties everything together, and I think it works great. A lot of times, like, I do wish that we live in a world where we accept everyone for who we are, because we're all human, we're all different, there's nuances. And just instead of focusing on power and superiority, focusing on health, well-being, and happiness, you know, unfortunately, that's not the world that we live in. But just the thought of that hope can help you move on. This is a great album. Lust for Life is a great album. So the people that already listened to this album, what were your first thoughts when you listened to this? Did you listen to this with a political lens? Or you just thought it was mostly about love? Like, what you thought about this when you first listened to this album? And what are your thoughts about it now? Let me know down in the comments below. Write down and give this video a like, subscribe to the channel. Remember to go to the community tab and post the albums that you want me to react to, and also give a like to those that you agree with. I want more people to participate. You don't have to comment Lana Del Rey. Like, Lana Del Rey season will always continue until I'm done. So yes, check the community tab. Thank you all for watching. Muchas bendiciones. Peace.